Welcome to today's video, where we'll be showing you how to enable debugging in WordPress. Debugging is an essential tool for WordPress developers, and it helps to identify and resolve issues in the code. In this video, we'll go over the steps to enable debugging in WordPress and how it can help with troubleshooting. So, let's get started. Example wp-config.php for debugging. First of all, you need to open the wp-config.php file located in the root folder of your WordPress site. You can FTP software or file browsers offered by your hosting provider, e.g., the ones from cPanel, to access and edit the wp-config.php file. The following code inserted in your wp-config.php file will log all errors, notices, and warnings to a file called debug.log in the WP content directory. It will also hide the errors so they do not interrupt page generation. Please note that you must insert this code before that's all, stop editing. Happy blogging! Line in the wp-config.php file, wp-debug. wp-debug is a PHP constant, a permanent global variable, that can be used to trigger the debug mode throughout WordPress. It is assumed to be false by default and is usually set to true in the wp-config.php file on development copies of WordPress. This enables debugging. This disables debugging. Note, the true and false values in the example are not surrounded by apostrophes because they are Boolean true slash false values. If you set constants to false, they will be interpreted as true because the quotes make it a string rather than a Boolean. It is not recommended to use wp-debug or the other debug tools on live sites. They are meant for local testing and staging installs. PHP errors, warnings, and notices. Enabling wp-debug will cause all PHP errors, notices, and warnings to be displayed. This is likely to modify the default behavior of PHP, which only displays fatal errors and slash or shows a white screen of death when errors are reached. Showing all PHP notices and warnings often results in error messages for things that don't seem broken, but do not follow proper data validation conventions inside PHP. These warnings are easy to fix once the relevant code has been identified, and the resulting code is almost always more bug-resistant and easier to maintain. Deprecated functions and arguments. Enabling wp-debug will also cause notices about deprecated functions and arguments within WordPress that are being used on your site. These are functions or function arguments that have not been removed from the core code yet but are slated for deletion in the near future. Deprecation notices often indicate the new function that should be used instead. wp-debug log. wp-debug log is a companion to wp-debug that causes all errors to also be saved to a debug.log log file. This is useful if you want to review all notices later or need to view notices generated off-screen, e.g., during an AJAX request or WP cron run. Note that this allows you to write to a log file using PHP built-in error log function, which can be useful, for instance, when debugging AJAX events. When set to true, the log is saved to debug.log in the content directory, usually wp-content/debug.log within your site's file system. Alternatively, you can set it to a valid file path to have the file saved elsewhere. Note that for wp-debug log to do anything, wp-debug must be enabled true. Remember, you can turn off wp-debug display independently. wp-debug display. wp-debug display is another companion to wp-debug that controls whether debug messages are shown inside the HTML of pages or not. The default is true, which shows errors and warnings as they are generated. Setting this to false will hide all errors. This should be used in conjunction with wp-debug log so that errors can be reviewed later. Note that for wp-debug display to do anything, wp-debug must be enabled true. Script debug. Script debug is a related constant that will force WordPress to use the dev versions of core CSS and JavaScript files rather than the minified versions that are normally loaded. This is useful when you are testing modifications to any built-in .js or .css files. Default is false. SAVEQUERIES. The SAVEQUERIES definition saves the database queries to an array, and that array can be displayed to help analyze those queries. The constant defined as true causes each query to be saved, how long that query took to execute, and what function called it. Please note that this will have a performance impact on your site, so make sure to turn this off when you aren't debugging. Debugging plugins. There are many debugging plugins for WordPress that show more information about the internals, either for a specific component or in general. Here are some examples. Query Monitor, Debug Bar, Log Deprecated Notices. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.